Hello everyone, you are welcome to our day 9 of our fifth month fasting and prayers. And the theme for this fasting is deliverance and glorification. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Today we are going to see the great works of God, the blessings, his compassion that he's going to use to overshadow us and overcome every of our difficulties in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
And before we start, I want to welcome everybody that is joining us. May God bless you. May God keep you and give you strength and understanding so that you will embrace this prayer and benefit from it in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Shall we pray just a short prayer before we start? Almighty and everlasting King, we thank you for this opportunity to pray together. We glorify your name because we know you are about to reveal to us your blessing, your love, your care for us. Mm-hmm. And as we listen and pray together, may we be blessed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Without so much this, we want to bring to you what God has placed in our heart during this fasting and prayer. He has given us some great and mighty words for you.
Thank you, Lord.
We will listen to these words before we go into the marathon prayer in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
And our scripture is coming from Isaiah, the book of Isaiah, chapter 54. Verse 1 says, "Sing, barren woman, you who never bore a child, burst into song, shout for joy, you who we are never in labor, because more are the children of the desolate woman than of her who has a husband, says the Lord."
Hallelujah.
When we talk about barrenness here, the barrenness here includes unfruitfulness in your endeavors, lack, emptiness, disappointments, stagnation, failures, living in desert of non-achievement, no progress, and no insight. But the Lord has said that you should wake up because he is about to turn things around in you. He has declared it and so shall it be. He said that the barren woman, he is going to turn this barrenness into fertility.
Amen.
And the children of this barren woman without a husband will be greater than the children of the woman with her husband, which means that he is going to call up your children from all corners of this earth.
Amen.
And you will be blessed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
In verse 2, it says, "Enlarge the place of your tent. Stretch your tent curtains wide. Do not hold back. Lengthen your cords. Strengthen your stakes." Hallelujah.
Amen.
This is God's command. He is commanding you. He is commanding us to stretch our tent left and right. And
yes,
as you are stretching left and right, he is expanding you proportionately back and forth.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Oh,
amen.
Hallelujah. He is going to turn this desert into fertile land.
Amen.
He is hallelujah. Telling you to move up.
Thank you, Jesus.
Don't let nothing hold you down. Don't look at any problem. Don't look at any situation. Just stand firm because he is God.
Amen.
He is handling every situation in your life.
Amen.
Everything that will make it impossible for you to move, he is bringing it forward.
Amen.
He's turning things around in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
And in verse 3, he says, "For you will spread out to the right and to the left. Your descendants will dispossess nations and settle in their desolate cities."
Amen.
And he further says, this expansion is not only for you. It's for your descendants. It's for your descendants.
Amen.
Your descendants will ultimately dispossess nations. That
Amen.
Is, they are coming up with strength, with power, with might.
Amen.
And they will possess things that will make them rich, make them outstanding. You will see the glorification of God in them because
Hallelujah.
For a barren woman to have children that will come to dispossess other nations, that shows you that
Thank you, Lord.
God is behind you.
Yes, Lord.
God is moving
Hallelujah.
With you.
Glory
so, rise up.
Name.
Obey this command.
Amen.
Don't let anything hold you down in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And in verse 4, it
Thank
says,
you,
"Do not be afraid. You will not be put to shame.
Hallelujah.
Do not fear disgrace.
Amen.
You will not be humiliated.
Amen.
You will forget the shame of your youth
Amen.
And remember no more the reproach of your widowhood."
Yes,
Hallelujah.
Lord. Thank
you know,
you,
most
Lord.
Of the time, when we are confronted with issues, we begin to fear, we begin to fret. But he's saying, you should fear not.
Amen.
Don't fear failure, because you will not fail.
Amen.
And he's saying, you will not be distressed.
Glory to God.
So rise up. Do what is needful. And God is with you. He will lead you and guide you. He said, forget the disgrace of the past.
Yes.
Those are gone. Put them behind and march forward. Because he who has placed his hand on the plow, you do not need to look back. Put your eyes on the prize. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Glory to God.
And verse 5 it says, for your maker is your husband.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Wonderful. Your maker is your husband.
Amen.
Oh, the Lord Almighty is his name.
Thank you.
The Holy One of Israel is your Redeemer. He is called the God of all the nations. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. On earth, we know what husbands are. Husbands are the providers for their family.
Yes.
But in this case, God is saying that he is the husband of the family, husband of the church, husband of the individual.
Amen.
And he is going to provide for you like no man ever can.
Thank
because
you.
His own provision is insurmountable. He cannot.
Thank you.
He provides in abundance. He provides beyond your wildest imagination.
Thank
Hallelujah.
You. Amen.
Thank you, mighty God.
Hallelujah.
You are a loving
Glory
King. And you know the greatest thing?
Glory
his word will never fall to the ground. Every
Amen.
Word he speaks must go out, reach out, flourish
Amen.
And fulfill the purpose for which it was spoken.
Yes,
Hallelujah.
Lord. Hallelujah.
We know God for whom he is. Hallelujah.
Glory to God.
And in verse 6, he says, the Lord will call you back
Amen.
As if you were a wife, deserted and distressed in spirit, a wife who married young only to be rejected, says the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
In the midst of your troubles, it's as if you are dejected. You are rejected. You know, when your people marry, they tend to drive away. But at times, they will realize and say, this is my apple. You will call them back. God will call you back.
Amen.
He will call you back. He will make you greater.
Amen.
He will change this in your life. He will make you great. Because when he calls you back, he's going to fortify you. He's going to bless you.
Hallelujah.
He's going to increase you. He's going to fight all your battles and
Thank
change things
Jesus.
Around you in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
In verse 7, it says, for a brief moment, I abandoned you. But with deep compassion, I will bring you back. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. Thank
you know,
Lord.
God does not have anything to do with sin.
Amen.
When he sees us in sin, he turns his back. But because he is a compassionate God,
yes.
he still turns around and brings you back.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Thank you.
And as he's bringing you back, he is blessing you. He's
yes,
not just
Lord.
Bringing you back, blessing
Hallelujah.
You, giving you a better position
Glory
that you had before he rejected you.
Glory
now, that time of waiting, you might think that God has forgotten you. God does not forget his own children.
Amen.
That time of waiting will be the time that will make you to have a remorse. And remember, you are in the wrong. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the
glory,
Lord.
Glory, glory. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
He continues again.
Thank
in verse 8, it says, in a surge of anger, I hid my face from you for a moment. But with everlasting kindness, I will have compassion on you.
Amen.
Says the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
This is who he is.
Thank
he gets annoyed, not forever. It's just for a moment.
Thank
he turns
you,
around
Lord.
And
Hallelujah.
Takes his children. Because he is a compassionate God. Because
Hallelujah.
He loves his children.
Thank
he loves
you,
us
Jesus.
Unconditionally.
Yes,
so
Lord.
He does not want you to be cast out permanently. He does that for a moment. And when you look up, you see God turning around to bring you back into his fold. Hallelujah.
Amen.
In verse 9, he says, to me, this is like the day of Noah.
Hallelujah.
When I swore that the waters of Noah will never again cover the earth, so now I have sworn not to be angry
Amen.
With you and never to rebuke you again.
Hallelujah.
You,
Amen.
You remember the waters of Noah when the world was destroyed with flood. At the end of the day, God made a covenant with Noah that he will never destroy the world again.
Amen.
And in remembrance, he gave rainbow so that anytime you look at the rainbow, you remember the covenant.
Amen.
God is saying that this forgiveness is like that covenant, an
Amen.
Everlasting covenant. That he has said it,
irrevocable.
And it is. It is irrevocable.
Amen.
You cannot change it again.
Thank
because
you.
He loves you, because he has a compassionate heart, because he wants you to
great
enjoy the great blessing he has for you.
We
Hallelujah.
You,
Father,
Amen.
You are a mighty King.
Thank
we
you,
thank
Lord.
You.
Thank you, Lord.
Number 10, he says, though the mountains be shaken and the hills be removed, yet my unfailing love for you
yes.
will never be shaken.
Amen.
Nor my covenant of peace
yes,
be removed,
Lord.
Says the Lord who has compassion. He is continuing in assuring you that he has changed. He has forgiven you. That you should come forward. You got to open your eyes, embrace God, and know his word. Because he's saying that. Listen to this. He has unfailing love. He said, even if the mountain is shaking, even if the hills is falling, that it does not matter that his love for you cannot shake. It is permanent. It is constant. He has said it, and it is his love.
Yes,
unchanging love. Hallelujah. Love with so much compassion. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Mighty God, we thank you because each time we get into what God is telling us, if we embrace it, every situation in our life is changed.
Glory,
and we begin to face and enjoy his blessings. Hallelujah. Thank you, mighty King. And in verse 11, he continued. He said, afflicted city, lashed by storm and not comforted, I will rebuild you with stones of turquoise. Your foundation will be with lapis lazuli. God says he will make you exceedingly beautiful. That's what
he said.
He is going to rebuild you. You will be more beautiful than you were.
Amen.
Now, this promise is to the church, to the individual, and to his children of earth.
Amen.
Not just one person. Everybody
that you know
God, that embraces God, this promise is for you.
Amen.
You see, when he is rebuilding you, he is going to fortify you with greater and beautiful precious stones. Imagine when you lay foundation with precious stone. What do you expect out of it? It's going to be great. It's going to be mighty. It's going to be lovely. So he's going to make you exceedingly beautiful.
Amen.
And pure.
Amen.
Stable and glorious.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Oh, mighty God.
Thank you.
Hallelujah.
Lord.
Let us embrace the word of God because his word is yes and amen.
Hallelujah.
And in verse 12, he says, I will make you battlement. That is saying that he will fortify you with rubies. Oh, his fortification will be with rubies. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Your gates are sparkling jewels.
Thank you, Father.
Your walls of precious stone.
Thank you, Lord.
The beautification will be in and out. He will beautify you spiritually and physically. People will see the glorification of the Lord on you.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Mighty God. His own wisdom is beyond comprehension.
Yes, Lord.
Guess who he's beautifying? It's the one that has offended him. The one that has sinned, but he's bringing you back. Because when God created you, he created you because he loves you.
Amen.
And he made you in his image.
Amen.
Will he cast away his own image?
No.
There's no way he can do that. Praise the Lord.
Thank you, God. God is mighty.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Then he went again to say, all your children will be taught by the Lord.
Amen.
And great will be their peace. Hallelujah.
Glory
this
to God.
He is not finished.
Hallelujah.
He is still bringing blessing upon blessing upon
Amen.
You. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now your children will be taught of the Lord.
Amen.
When he's talking about teaching of the Lord, he's going to teach you inside the word and
mentor.
The spiritual. He will be their mentor. Hallelujah.
God will mentor.
Oh, God will mentor our children.
Hallelujah.
And you know when God is mentoring your children,
Hallelujah.
You know what you expect.
Yes,
you
Lord.
Expect nothing but the best.
Perfection.
Hallelujah. That
Hallelujah.
Is perfection.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
And in verse 14, it says, in righteousness you will be established.
Amen.
Tyranny will be far from you.
Amen.
You will have nothing to fear.
Amen.
Terror will be far removed.
Amen.
It will not come near you.
Amen.
You see,
no terror.
When God has called
You're
you in,
afraid.
You are expected to be righteous.
Glory
and in righteousness, anything when God is dealing with you in righteousness, hallelujah.
Amen.
Everything is changing. He removes you. He keeps you in peace.
Amen.
You have peace all over you.
Amen.
No tyranny.
Thank
no agony.
Lord.
No pain.
Lord.
No sickness.
Lord.
No disease. Everything. You
Lord,
have that perfect peace that passes all understanding
Amen.
That is only God that can give.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
In verse 15 it says, if anyone does attack you, it will not be my doing. Whoever attacks
Hallelujah.
You will surrender. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You see, God does
Thank
not
you,
allow
Lord.
His children to suffer any trouble.
Amen.
No matter the trouble people begin,
Thank you, Lord.
It does not matter. He said that they will gather. But that, if that gathering is not of him, they will certainly scatter.
Amen.
Every gathering that is not of the Lord will certainly scatter. So Amen. No matter the gathering, they will surrender unto you. That's what Amen. The Lord has said. Hallelujah. Amen. Fear not. Hallelujah. Be strong.
Amen.
And do whatever God has asked you to do. You will succeed because he has told you already, you will have no shame. You will not be destroyed. You will not be shamed.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Yeah. And in verse 16, he says, see it. See, it is I who created the blacksmith,
mm-hmm.
who fans the coals into flame,
mm-hmm.
and forges a weapon fit for its work.
Mm.
And it is I who have created the destroyer to wreak havoc. Mm. Hallelujah.
Mm. Amen.
When God creates all these things, it means he is the owner of the entire universe. Anything, and he has perfect, I repeat, perfect control over all. So no matter any weapon anybody brings around, God is already in control because he created them.
Glory,
he owns them. He has power over everything. And he has told you in verse 17, no weapon forged against you will prosper.
Amen.
And you will refute every tongue Amen. That accuses you.
Amen.
This is the heritage of the servants of the Lord.
Amen.
And this is their vindication from me.
Amen. Declares the Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Is there any other thing we know? God has given us protection east, west, north, and south, left and right, anywhere. All corners.
Hallelujah.
He said, no matter any weapon they bring against you, he will succumb to the greater power of the Lord.
Amen.
He says that no matter their gathering, he will wipe them off.
Glory to God.
They will turn back in shame.
Amen.
They will come in one way and they will scatter in seven ways.
Amen.
Deliverance is your portion in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
God has finished it. He finished it before we began.
Yes, Lord.
So because it is a perfect and well-articulated promise
Amen.
That God gave to us.
Mm.
Embrace the promise of God and you will be blessed. Hallelujah. Yes.
Thank you, Lord.
Now you have heard the promises of God. We what are going to go into powerful prayers. Powerful prayers created in 9 powerful points.
Thank you, Lord.
And I will now invite Pastor Bridget to lead us in this powerful prayer. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. He is an awesome God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you for your word. We give you praise. We give you honor and adoration. These are powerful words and the promises of God. They are not empty promises. God is an awesome God. When he promises, he stands by his word to perform it. Thank
Hallelujah.
You, Lord. Hallelujah. So we are going to go into a session of prayer. We are going to pray on our prayer points. And God is here. He's here to hear and to do, even as we are going to pray right now, for he says that if we pray according to his will, he hears us. And if he hears us, we know that we have the petition that we desired of him. So God hears our petitions and he delivers them to us because we are praying according to his will. Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
There is a song that says, nothing he cannot do. I love it. There is nothing that is too hard for God. He says, I am the Lord, the God of all flesh. Is there anything that is too hard for me? And we know that the answer is no. There is nothing that is too hard for God. Nothing he cannot do. Nothing he cannot change. Nothing he cannot turn around. He is able, the great and mighty God. I put my trust in you. You are able, Jesus. Yes, nothing you cannot do. Nothing you cannot change. Nothing you cannot turn around. You are able. You are the great and mighty God. You are able, Jesus. nothing you cannot do, nothing you cannot change, nothing you cannot turn around. You are able, you are the great and mighty God, you are able, Jesus. Hallelujah. There is nothing he cannot change. Our God is an able God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Nothing you cannot turn around. No situation is difficult for you, O Lord, to handle. We praise you, Lord. You have brought us to the banqueting table, and your banner over us is love. Lord, we thank you. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not his benefit. He heals my sicknesses. He heals my diseases. He crowns me with loving kindness. Lord, we bless you. We give you glory. Lord, we thank you for the power of your word. We give you glory. We give you praise. We honor your holy name. Thank you, Lord Jesus. You have given to us everything that pertains to life and godliness through your son, Jesus Christ. We worship you, Lord. We praise your holy name. We give you glory, our Abba, Father. Abba, Father. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you for this opportunity to come before your presence. We thank you, God. This is the confidence that we have in you, that if we shall ask anything according to your will, you hear us. And we thank you because of all these prayers, of all the prayer points that we are going to pray on, Lord. We just thank you because you are here to hear us. You are here to answer us. You are here to deliver us. You are here to turn the situations around. In the mighty name of Jesus, we praise you, Lord. We praise you, King of Kings. We praise you, Lord of Lords. You have said in your word that if you can give us Jesus Christ, the most precious gift, how can you not with him give us everything freely to enjoy? Our God, we praise you. We honor you. Great is your faithfulness. Great is your faithfulness, morning by morning. New message we see, Father. Today, in the name of Jesus, every prayer request, Lord, in the name of Jesus, as we pray on them, Lord, we know that every one of them will receive answers in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Oh, we thank you because of this blessed assurance that you are with us, oh Lord, and all things are possible before you. For Jesus said, there is nothing impossible with God. All things are possible with you. Lord, thank you because God, as we call upon your name, you hear us.
Amen.
We worship and exalt your holy name.
Hallelujah.
Blessed be your name, O Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus, glory Amen. To God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. And so now we are going to go into our first prayer request. We are going to pray and thank God for breaking the siege of barrenness, the siege of unfruitfulness, the siege of lack and emptiness, the siege of disappointment, the siege of stagnation and failures. We are going to bind them in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
God has given us his power.
Amen.
God has given us his authority. He said that he will remove all barrenness, every spirit of unfruitfulness, every spirit of barrenness, every spirit of unproductiveness. In the mighty name of Jesus, we bind them and we cast them out in Jesus' name. Our Father, we thank you, King of Kings and Lord of Lords. We have come into your presence with a full assurance that God, it is not your will for any of your children to be barren. So every spirit of barrenness, we know the source of it. We know you are not the source. God, in the name of Jesus, every spirit of barrenness, we come against it And we nullify it in every one of our lives. In Jesus' name, we take authority over every unproductiveness. In the name of Jesus, we come against it and we nullify them. In Jesus' name, they are not for us, because Jesus Christ has died on the cross. Jesus Christ has delivered us from the spirit of barrenness, from the spirit of unproductiveness. Jesus Christ died on the cross to give us everything that pertains to life and to godliness. Jesus has made available. So anything that is contrary to the plan of God for our lives, we destroy it and we nullify it and we stand against it and we reject it in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
That Jesus said that we should pray that the will of God be done. The will of God is what is contained in the Bible, in the Word of God. So the spirit of barrenness is not from God. The spirit of unproductiveness is not from God. The spirit of stagnation is not from God. And therefore, we nullify them and we cast them out and we reject them in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen. Amen.
We stand on the authority of the word of God. We appropriate the word of God. We receive the word of God into our personal lives. We receive the word of God into our families. We receive the word of God into our community. We receive the word of God in all the families. We decree and declare that the will of God be done in our personal lives, in our family, in our children, in our community, in the kingdom citizens, in the world. And the name of God be glorified and the kingdom of God be established on earth in the name of Jesus. Everything that opposes the word of God in our lives, we come against them. We raise up the banner of the name of Jesus and we dethrone them in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Every spirit of barrenness, unproductiveness, stagnation, sadness, depression, all emotional problems, in the mighty name of Jesus, we come against them in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. We call forth the spirit of fruitfulness that is from God. God said that he will make us fruitful. Hallelujah. He said he will make us fruitful. He turns barrenness into fruitfulness. Thank you, Lord, for that. In the mighty name of Jesus, Amen. We receive your fruitfulness. Amen. In our lives.
Amen.
We receive your fruitfulness in our family. We receive your fruitfulness in our children.
Amen.
We receive your fruitfulness in our church. We receive your fruitfulness in our community. We receive your fruitfulness in the world. We receive the fruitfulness in Ireland. We receive your power in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
We give you glory.
Hallelujah.
We give you praise.
Hallelujah.
We give you adoration.
Hallelujah.
In the mighty name
Hallelujah.
Of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Every desert, every non-achievement, you know, when people don't achieve anything, in Jesus' name, we break that yoke of non-achievement in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
And he says there's no prospect, there is no insight. Some people are just living life, no prospect, no insight. It's not the will of God. So we are going to bind the spirit of not having insight. Because you have to have insight and you have to know what God wants you to do at any given time. So the children of God, God has promised that he will give us insight, because the wisdom of God, the fear of God is the beginning of wisdom. When you get wisdom, you get understanding, you get knowledge, and you get insight. And now, in the name of Jesus, every spirit of lack of insight, in Jesus' name, we overcome it. We overcome. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Bible said that we are seated in the heavenly places with Jesus. Hallelujah. Far above principalities, far above powers. Everything that diminishes people's life, Jesus has redeemed us. Jesus has reclaimed us. Jesus has lifted us up. Lifted, lifted, lifted far above principalities, far above powers. We are in the kingdom. We are in the kingdom. So we receive inspiration. We receive insight. We receive anointing. We receive good, sound mind. Hallelujah. We have sound mind from God. Lord, we thank you for sound mind. Sound mind that leads us to insight, to great achievement, to great accomplishment. Father, we bless you. We give you glory. We give you praise in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen,
amen and amen. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now, let us thank God for taking away sorrow from us. He says, I will wear you the garment of praise. So taking away the spirit of heaviness, and he's giving us the oil of joy, taking away and then wearing us the garment of praise. So now let us pray. Anything heavy spirit is not from us, it's not from God, and it's not for us. So now, spirit of mourning, remember Jesus said that the spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because we are the people, we are the representatives of Jesus Christ. We cannot be mournful, we cannot be mourning. We have received Jesus, the spirit of Jesus is living in us. He has taken away the garment of mourning and worn us the garment of praise. So in Jesus' name, everything that causes people to mourn, we nullify them in our personal lives, in our family lives, in our children, in our church, in our community, in our country, Ireland, and we nullify them around the world for the children of God, those who believe in the name of the Lord, and those who don't believe, so that they will receive the grace of God that leads them to salvation. Let us pray right now, nullifying everything that is contrary to the plan of God for our lives. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. He has given us joy. He has given us garment of praise. And we go about praising the name of the Lord. We cannot be caged. We cannot be put down. We cannot be, devil cannot cage us in Jesus' mighty name. So we are free. Hallelujah. Bible said that if the Son shall make you free, ye shall be free. Indeed, we are free from the spirit of mourning. We are free from the spirit of oppression. We are free from every spirit that pulls us down. And we now receive the garment of praise to praise the Lord. Our spirit are free in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen,
amen and amen.
Hallelujah.
And he has given us the oil of joy. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Joy is our portion.
Amen.
Father, we thank you. For joy is our portion. Thank you for what Jesus has done on the cross. We give you glory. We give you praise. We honor your name. We receive all that Jesus Christ has purchased for us on the cross. We will not accept any parcel from the devil in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We nullify the power of the devil in our lives, in our family, in our community, in our nation, in the world. Let the will of God be done in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
And amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. We give you glory.
Hallelujah.
Now we're going to pray. It says we should pray for birth of new and fruitful ideas. Ideas. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God has created us in his image.
That's right.
God is never short of ideas.
No.
So because we are in the image of God, you see, ideas are the things that when you translate them into physical products, those are the things that make people great. And Bible says that a man's gift shall make way for him and will bring him before kings. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God wants us to come before kings. God wants us to speak. He said, he talks about Jesus Christ. He said, when Jesus was speaking, he said that people, they were wondering, what kind of wisdom does this man have? Look at the powerful words, authoritative words that are coming from, and we are in his image. So now we are asking God for the birth of ideas in the name of Jesus. For the birth of ideas. We cannot lack ideas. Because God has created us in his image. We are tapped into his the realm of his spirit. We receive the ideas of God. We receive the inspiration of God. We receive the divine knowledge of God in the name of Jesus. Anyone, Bible says, if anyone lacks wisdom, let him ask of God, who gives to all men without upbraiding. So we receive that idea that generates business and generates income. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Father, Lord, in the name of Jesus, we pray for divine inspiration, the divine ideas in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Lord God Almighty, that you will come and flood us with ideas in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. We will be exactly what you say we will be. You said we shall not lack. Father, we will not be bankrupt of ideas. We will not be bankrupt of things, Lord. There will always be a way that you want us to do things, Lord, so that we will prosper. Because you said you are the Lord that teaches us how to make profit. In the mighty name of Jesus, we receive that idea. Our young people, they will receive that idea in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord, because you said that you will pour your spirit upon all flesh, and that our sons and our daughters, that they will prophesy. Our young men will see vision. Young people, they will see vision. Lord, that's ideas that are planted in them by the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And they will translate all those ideas, and God, those ideas will prosper and be fruitful in Jesus' name.
Amen.
God, we thank you because you have said this. We receive it in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen,
amen and amen. Amen. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Now, we are going to pray for God has said we should enlarge. Hallelujah. God doesn't want us to think small. God said we should spread out. God said we should enlarge our coast.
That's right.
Remember when he came before Abraham? You know what excites me? What excites me is that when God came to Abraham, Abraham was 75 years of age. And God called him out. Now we are called out just like Abraham, because we share in the faith of Abraham. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And God said, just look and see all this I'm going to give to you and your descendants.
That's right.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
God doesn't want us to be bankrupt. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God doesn't want us to be eating cheese and spiritual cheese and crackers.
Amen.
No, 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 no. God wants us to spread out. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We want to spread out, to bet great ideas, to spread out, to see great visions. And that's what God said, I will do. He said, we cause your sons and daughters to see visions, great visions. So right now, that's what we are praying for, that the vision and the revelation of the Lord, hallelujah, we receive it. We receive the visions and the revelations of the Lord. The visions and revelations of the Lord, they make us great. God wants us to be great. Hallelujah.
Amen.
See, Jesus said, anyone who wants to be great must be the servant of all. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So if we want to be great, you have to have something that you are going to serve your community with.
Yes.
So you serve and you serve your way to greatness. So when we expand, when we have great ideas, we receive that power to and that thing to serve our community. And that's what makes us great. Amen. So right now, we spread. Our tent spread.
Amen.
God said to Abraham, just look at the sky. Will you be able to number the stars of the sky? If you are able to number them. If you are not able to number them, that's how much I'm going to expand you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory to God. So we are going to spread and blossom. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That is what God wants us to do.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. We give you glory. We give you praise that we are spreading in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Amen and amen. Glory to God. So the spirit of boldness to confront all obstacles. We are going to pray. Bible said that God has not given us the spirit of fear. Fear is not in our dictionary because we have the DNA of God. Hallelujah. We are not afraid. In the name of Jesus, we are not afraid. Hallelujah. God has not given us the spirit of fear. We spread. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. We have the spirit of boldness. We are bold. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Bible said that the righteous is as bold as lion.
Hallelujah.
We are not timid. No circumstance can intimidate us. No power can intimidate us. No demon can intimidate us. Because we are in Christ. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We are in Christ. We are bold. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The spirit of boldness is upon us. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So now, anyone that has the spirit of timidity is not of God. Yeah, Bible said that whatever is born of God overcomes the world.
Wow.
This is our victory that overcomes the world, even our faith in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Every spirit of timidity, we cast it out in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
When they said that spirit of power and anointing, is there anyone that is timid? We cast away the spirit of timidity from your life, from your family, from your community, in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory to God. You know what? Jesus Christ is called the Lion of the tribe of Judah. Glory to God.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Amen.
So we are the lion, the lionesses. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God.
Amen.
We worship
Amen.
You, Lord. No fear, no shame. God has said, we will not be ashamed.
Amen.
We will not be confounded.
Amen.
Nobody that believes in God will be confounded. We will not.
Amen.
It's not even something to talk about. We will not. We believe the word of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We believe the word of God. Bible said that with faith we obtain the promise. Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. We believe the entirety of the word of God. Every spirit of doubt, every spirit of timidity is not of God. We cast it out in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Jesus said, behold, I give unto you power to tread on serpents and scorpions and over all the powers of the enemy. Nothing shall by any means hurt you. Hallelujah. So why should we be afraid? Why should we be timid? In Jesus' name, we come against them.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
And verse 4, God says, we have to thank God, for God is our maker. He has taken full charge of us. He is the Lord. He is the Lord. What does it mean? God is the Lord, the owner. He owns
Hallelujah.
Us. Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
He is the one that redeemed us. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And he is called the Lord of all the earth. He is in control. He is in charge. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That the people that do know the name of their God, they shall be strong and they shall do exploits. Thank
Amen.
You, Lord, for
Hallelujah.
Exploit.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord, for exploit.
Amen.
We do exploit in the name of the Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. Glory
Amen.
To God.
Hallelujah.
Point number 5. Let us pray and thank God for turning away his anger. God said, I was angry with you just momentarily. But God says, I will never be angry with you again. That is great news. That means we can serve the Lord with joy. We can serve the Lord with gladness. Lord, we praise your holy name. Hallelujah. Thank you. You have begotten us in the beloved. Jesus Christ is the beloved of his Father. And he has brought us in. The way God sees Jesus is the way he sees us. He said he will not be angry again with us. Why? Because we are called the seeds of righteousness. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Amen. Hallelujah. Father, thank you for this promise. Thank you for your word. Glory to God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. We give you glory. We give you praise. Great are your words to us, and we appropriate your word. Amen. We appropriate your word. Amen. Every form of ignorance of your word, Lord, we cast them out in the name of Jesus.
Amen. Amen.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. God said that he has an everlasting kindness for us. Hallelujah. Yes. Our everlasting compassion. Glory to God. So it's not a question of saying, oh, God, please. God, no. God said, appropriate my word. Yes. Believe my word. Hallelujah. Trust my word. Walk in the word. Hallelujah. Walk in the light. Hallelujah. In the light of the word of God.
Praise
Hallelujah,
God.
Father. We thank you. Thank we you, give Lord. You glory. We give you praise. We give you honor. We give you adoration in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you,
Amen.
Lord, for joy. Amen. Of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Number 6 is a prayer and thank God for his covenant. Not to be angry with us again. Never again rebuke us. Remember, he has a covenant. He's a covenant-keeping God.
Hallelujah.
Great is his faithfulness. Oh. Our God is a covenant-keeping God. So let's thank him for his faithfulness. Great is your faithfulness. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We bless you. We give you glory. We give you praise. You are a covenant-keeping God. Amen. You are the El Shaddai, the mighty God, Amen. The everlasting Father, and the Prince of Peace. Amen. Lord, we thank you for Jesus Christ. We know you, Lord. We've come into you, Lord, in the name of Jesus. And the light is shining. Amen. The true light is shining Amen. In us and through us. Amen. In Jesus' name. Amen. And we are the light of the world. Amen. We are a city that is built on top of the hill. We cannot be hidden. We are Amen. Dishing out the light. Amen. And people are coming to the light of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Because he said the Gentiles shall come to your light.
Hallelujah.
Lord, in the name of Jesus,
Amen.
We praise your holy name.
Hallelujah.
We give you glory.
Hallelujah.
We give you praise.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Thank you for Jesus.
Amen.
We thank you, Lord,
Amen.
For everything that you have given to us through Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory, glory, glory to God.
Glory be to the Lord.
Hallelujah. Amen. It says, let us pray. And thank God, for he said, our children shall be taught by the Lord. Hallelujah. God said he will teach our children. So now we appropriate that word. And he said that God calls those things that be not as though they were. You may say, oh, look at my children. Well, they're not really what they're supposed to be now. Don't worry about that. God said, I will mentor your children by myself. Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Heavenly Father, we thank you for sweet are your promises. And God, these are not empty promises. And we thank you because our children are coming to you. Lord, those that are not in you already, Father, they are coming to you. And you will be their mentor. Even as you have spoken through your word in the name of Jesus, we are not worried. We are not concerned about them because God, you will teach them by yourself. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord God Almighty. We give you glory. We give you praise. We give you adoration. Lord, every yoke of the enemy over our children are broken in the mighty name of Jesus. Every manipulation of the enemy over their lives are broken in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, we call them forth. You said that your children shall return from the land of the dead, the spiritually dead. They will return in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And we thank you because it is done in Jesus. Jesus' mighty name. Amen and amen.
Hallelujah.
Glory be to God. Glory be to God. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Glory be to God. And then it says, let us worship God in the beauty of holiness, for he created the blacksmith. You see, God said, no weapon that is formed against you shall prosper. God said, listen, I am the one that created the blacksmith. I am the one, you know, the blacksmith that makes the weapons. And I am the one that created the people that use the weapon. He said, no weapon that is formed against you shall prosper. Any tongue that shall rise up against you, you will condemn it. It is you that will condemn it, because God has given you the authority to condemn them.
Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. We give you glory. Hallelujah. Thank you for the power of the Holy Spirit. Thank you for the power and the right of sonship. We have the power. We have the right of sonship. Every weapon of the enemy, none of them will be effective on us. None of them will be effective on our families. Nobody, none of them will be effective on our community, on the people of God, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh, thank you, Lord. 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 Father, we use this opportunity to pray for the people who do not know you yet. Father, we want them to come into the banqueting table that you have prepared, because they need this covering. Because your word said, he that dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Oh, hallelujah. Father God, those who have not already come into the secret place of the Most High, we pray for them. Break the yoke of the enemy over their lives and let them come into the kingdom in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Father, let your will be done on earth. Let your will be done on individual lives in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
We give you glory.
Amen.
We give you praise.
Hallelujah.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now, we are going to pray. 9, it says, finally, let us pray for Ireland and all the nations of the earth, using Psalm 2, verse 1 to 4. I will read that. It says, why do the heathen rage and the people imagine a vain thing? He said, the kings of the earth set themselves and the rulers take counsel together against the Lord and against his anointed, saying, let us break their bands asunder and cast away their cords from us. He says, he that sitteth in the heavens shall laugh. The Lord shall have them in derision. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Lord shall have them in derision. You know, when the presidents, when the kings of the earth, when the prime ministers of the earth, when the CEOs of the companies, all the rulers of the earth, they take counsel together to formulate policies that are detrimental to God. God says, I will sit in heaven and I will laugh at them, because their policy will be nullified.
Amen.
It will be null and void. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So right now, in the name of Jesus, we are going to take authority over all the manipulations of the enemy, all the machination of the devil over the against the church. Jesus says, I will build my church and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. So now, every part of the world, when the world leaders, when they are taking all their counsels together against the Lord to plan things that are anti-kingdom of God, that are planning things that anti-church, right now, God said that he will laugh at them. It will not hold.
Amen.
It will not stand.
Amen.
We nullify it.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Lord, we thank you, because only your will be done.
Amen.
Only your will take control, oh God, in all our countries of the earth, in Ireland, in the name of Jesus. Amen. All the policies that are not in line with your word, Father, we nullify them in the name of Jesus. Father, Lord God, we come as a whole in the world, all the different countries of the world and their leaders, in the name of Jesus. Every counsel of Ahithophel that is contrary to the word of God, that is contrary to the kingdom of God, we nullify them by the authority of the name of Jesus, and we cast them down and we put them under our feet in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Lord, we thank you. We give you glory. We give you praise. And Lord, now we want to pray for our world. The plague that is claiming people's lives around the world. Lord, in the name of Jesus, we pray that God, that you will deliver people. You will heal, bring healing to these people, Father God. All the people that are sick of coronavirus or any sickness or the other around the world, Lord, in the name of Jesus, we lift them up before you. God, we pray that in this situation, they will see the Lord. Jesus said, I am the one that has the keys of death and Hades. That means they cannot die unless you approve it. Lord, in the name of Jesus, we pray that these people in this situation, Father, through this situation, they will come to know you. They will come to know your power. They will be delivered. They will be made whole in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Our Father, we thank you. We give you glory. We give you praise and adoration for your healing power. Father, Lord, thank you, Jesus. Glory be to your name. All over the world, the Spirit of God is moving. All over the world, as the waters cover the sea, as the Spirit, as the prophet said, it will be. Lord, we declare your Spirit. The Spirit of God is moving all over the world. Hallelujah. Amen. Causing deliverance, causing healing, causing salvation from sin, from sickness, from satanic powers. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We give you glory. Let's sing it. All over the world, the Spirit is moving. All over the world, as the prophet said it should be. All over the world, there is a mighty revelation of the glory of the Lord as the water cover the sea. All over the world, the Spirit is moving. All over the world, as the prophet said it should be. All over the world, there is a mighty revelation of the glory of the Lord as the waters cover the sea. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We prophesy that dry bones will live again in our world in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We prophesy life. We prophesy the water, the river flowing from the presence of God will permeate the whole earth and bring deliverance in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And bring healing in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And bring prosperity in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And bring deliverance, oh Lord, to all the people. Oh Lord, healing across the world. Healing across the world.
Amen.
Healing across the world.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Oh Lord, so that the whole world will know that you are God. That they will know that you have reclaimed back their lives.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. We give you glory. We give you praise. Thank you, Father. Oh, hallelujah. Let us lift up our hands and thank the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let us thank him for great things he has done.
Amen.
Great things he has done. Hallelujah. We worship his name.
Amen.
Let's worship his name. Let's give him, thank him for the great things that God has done. Thank you for answering our prayers. Thank you for delivering the people. Thank you for making whole. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for pouring the outpouring of your Holy Spirit upon all corners of the earth. Hallelujah. We give you glory. Hallelujah. We give you honor. Amen. You are blessed and it cannot be reversed in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Go and prosper and may the Lord be always with you in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen. And amen.
Glory to God.
We want to thank you for joining us, and we know that having joined in this prayer,
hallelujah,
the mighty God is destroying all barriers in your life.
Amen.
It's lifting you to higher places.
Yes, Lord.
It's creating that boldness in you.
Yes, Lord.
It's creating greater ideas in you.
Amen.
It's making you flourish.
Amen.
And it's bringing favor in your way.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you,
Lord.
Tomorrow we shall gather again at 6, the same time.
Hallelujah.
Make sure you join.
Amen.
Because the word of God is flowing from his fountain.
Amen.
And is bringing life.
Amen.
Is bringing peace.
Amen.
Is bringing healing in
Amen.
Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah.
God bless you.
God bless you.
Hallelujah.
And until we meet again,
God bless you.
Shalom.
Shalom.